Hello students, welcome to the session. We'll continue with the topic tongue diagnosis. Here several abnormal tongue colors are displayed on this picture. So among them, the most common seen is purple tongue. So purple tongue is due to the phlegm dampness, the accumulation of phlegm. And then purple tongue, there is another picture which is also swollen, purple color and swollen due to excess of in cold. So next color is bluish tongue. So mainly the bluish tongue is due to stagnation of qi or blood. Purple tongue is also associated with excess of heat which is interiorly. Then there is also, we can look at the purple tongue due to kidney and stomach in exhaustion. So to summarize the summarization of the tongue body color, pink reflects normal or mild disorder. Pale color represents yang deficiency, blood or qi deficiency too. Otherwise, it also reflects deficiency of cold. It is reflected with thin and dry. It is equal to blood deficiency. Deficiency of cold, there is thin and dry tongue. And also, there may be sometimes wet, which is associated with qi deficiency, and swollen with qi deficiency. And there may be swollen and wet, that indicates yang deficiency. To repeat, yang, blood or qi deficiency reflected with pale color. In deficiency of cold, it refers to thin and dry with only blood deficiency. Wet indicates qi deficiency, swollen again qi deficiency. Red color, tongue, especially referring to heat. If there is no coating, that indicates indeficiency along with the heat. If there is yellow coat, which indicates excess of heat. And if there is dryness, it indicates there is some disturbance in the body fluid. Red tick tongue indicates heart fire excess. Red side of the tongues represents liver fire. Red with small points on the tongue indicates heat toxicity. Crimson red color indicates external heat, more severe condition than red. Purple color indicates excess of heat, in cold, blood stasis, phlegm, damp, and it may be due to alcoholic toxicity. Then blue color, there is an internal in cold syndrome. Sometimes it may be wholly bluish tongue. Blood stasis also represented by blue color at the side of the tongue. Then in the texture, what we need to see, texture and shape of the tongue. So normal tongue and texture, mainly it is subtle, or it is otherwise known as soft. Neither too flappy or too stiff. There won't be any cracks. So it, when the person is asked to stretch the tongue, he will not tremble. It will not be swollen or it will not be too thin. And even we don't find any ulcers over the tongue. As a general rule, the normal tongue shape changes only when there is a pathological conditions which persist for longer period of time. So tongue body shape, normally the body shape reflects the state of blood or yin, which is known as nutritive qi. Excess or deficiency constitution can also affect the shape of the tongue body. What is indicated by stiff tongue? Stiff tongue, a stiff or rigid tongue is difficult to move or protrude. This may normally cause any speech disorders or sometimes slurred or mumbled speech. So a stiff tongue is an indication of excess or often one of the internal vent. So if the stiff tongue is also associated with a purple body, then indicates potential or impending wind stroke. If a stiff tongue is accompanied by a bright red tongue body, it is usually indicates heat in the heart and pericardium disturbing the spirit or the energy. And in sometimes, if there is a thick sticky coating with the stiff tongue, it indicates there is phlegm overwhelming the heart. If the tongue is flaccid, then again it is opposite to that of the stiff tongue. Again, it is difficult to move. It indicates weak and lack of strength. It usually indicates deficiency when the heat has consumed and damaged the body fluids. They cannot rise to nourish the tongue. This can indicate even indeficiency. Qi deficiency and blood deficiency also the indicator of flaccid tongue. A flaccid tongue which is pale indicates there is a deficiency of blood. Swollen. Normally we see this big tongue. Normally it is big tongue is termed in conventional medicine due to deficiency, glossitis or even vitamin B12 deficiency. But in TCM, the very large tongue indicate the excess and sometimes it is deficiency. It depends on the nature of the tongue. A swollen tongue that is also pale can indicate deficiency. A swollen tongue which is very red in color indicates the excess. Big tongue, or it's otherwise known as enlarged tongue. An enlarged tongue indicates the phlegm, damp or water stagnation. So here there may be disturbance in the kidney function, because kidney and urinary bladder together responsible for controlling the water or water metabolism. Then the tongue may look like a hammer shape. So here enlarged at the side, the tongue is enlarged at the side. So here again it indicates the spleen, stomach and kidney deficiency. Short and contracted tongue. When the tongue is very short, indicates more severe disease. Contracted means very difficult to stretch it completely. So it is also associated with more moist, pale and stagnation of cold. If the color is bluish, again there is a spleen yang deficiency. If the tongue is too long, it difficulty in retracting the tongue, backward folding is difficult, that indicates again excess. The front part is swollen, it indicates the deficiency or disturbance in the lung energy. If the tongue is very thin and it is moist, that indicates again along with the pale color, it indicates the qi and blood deficiency. There are certain abnormal colors and the tongue pictures. So here tender tongue, so very patient will have in pain and reddish color, and even touching become very sensitive. So that is bulgy tongue, and sometimes it is very with cracks in the, especially in the stomach and GIT area, which indicates there is a severe disturbance in the digestion. To summarize, the tender tongue indicates delicate, fine, smooth, moist and lustrous surface, light color and bulgy appearance. Indicates deficiency syndrome, it may be yang or yin qi, and also associated with cold syndrome. Tough tongue, that is tough, dirty surface, and there is a dull color, which indicates excess syndrome and also associated with heat. Bulgy tongue, deficiency syndrome. Swollen tongue, excess syndrome with the heat, heart and spleen involvement. Thin tongue indicates the qi and blood deficiency, consumption of yin fluid. Fissured tongue, it's one of the very important aspect to be considered, which indicates deficiency of the essence of blood. Excessive heat consumption fluid and especially there will be lot of health issues. Prickly tongues indicates excess of heat, toxic heat, and tooth impressions over the tongue especially indicates deficiency of qi, sometimes it is yang or yin qi, and also there is retention of dampness. So this, by using the different color, the shape and structure of the tongue, we can identify the excess or deficiency in the five elements as well as in the internal organs, and we should try to correlate these colors along with the patient's symptoms and signs, and also the other factors like psychological factors, which would help us to proper diagnosis and proper management. Thank you.